robot controller typically accepts a steady stream of desired robot configurations, reads joint sensors to determine the robot's actual configuration, and updates the actuator commands to follow the desired configuration. This process can happen thousands of times a second. A robot configuration as a function of time is called a trajectory. We can write a trajectory as theta of t, where the time t goes from 0 to capital T. This figure shows a trajectory for a robot with 2 degrees of freedom. We could also plot this trajectory directly in the configuration space, also known as the C space. As the time t increases from 0 to capital T, the configuration follows the path shown here. In some cases, it is desirable to separate the C space path from the speed at which it's followed. For example, we might plan a geometric path for a mobile robot to avoid obstacles on the floor without worrying about how fast the path is followed. We define a path to be a curve in configuration space as a function of a path parameter, s, that goes from 0 to 1. As s increases from 0, the robot moves from the start configuration at theta of 0 to the end configuration at theta of 1. A path can be turned into a trajectory by defining a function s of t, which maps the time range 0 to capital T to the path parameter range 0 to 1. This function is called a time scaling. The time scaling controls how fast the path is followed. Now, with the trajectory theta of s of t, the time derivative of theta dot is determined by the chain rule to be d theta ds times s dot. The acceleration, theta double dot, is determined by the product rule and the chain rule to be d theta ds times s double dot plus d squared theta ds squared times s dot squared. Since the dynamics depend on theta double dot, for the dynamics to be well defined, the second derivatives of both theta of s and s of t must exist. In this chapter, we consider the problem of planning paths and trajectories without considering obstacles. In chapter 10, on motion planning, we address the case of obstacles in the environment. Let's start by planning a path for a robot arm in its C space. The simplest type of path is a straight line path from an initial configuration, theta start, to a final configuration, theta end, as described by this equation. As s goes from 0 to 1, the configuration goes from theta start to theta end. A straight line path in joint space is shown here for a 2R robot with 180 degrees of motion about its first joint and 150 degrees of motion about its second joint. The path can also be visualized in the workspace, as shown here. Note that the endpoint of the robot does not follow a straight line. If we prefer a straight line motion of the end effector in Cartesian space, we can define x to be the coordinates of the end effector and define a straight line path as shown here. Then we have to use inverse kinematics to solve for the robot configuration at each point along the path. As you can see here, some straight lines in Cartesian space cannot be executed as they pass outside the workspace. One advantage of planning straight line motions in joint space is that the joint limits are usually independent of each other, so the set of feasible joint configurations is convex, unlike the workspace. A straight line between two points in a convex space always remains inside the space. We can also plan a path between two rigid body frames represented in SE3. We could try directly extending our straight line definition in joint space, but of course this does not make sense. There is no meaning to subtracting two elements of SE3. Let's find the screw path where the frame follows a constant twist from x start to x end. First, let's express the frame x end relative to x start. Each of x start and x end is implicitly defined in a space frame, S. So by our subscript cancellation rule, we find that x start inverse times x end is the configuration of the end frame and the start frame. The log of this is the little SE3 representation of the twist expressed in the start frame that takes the start frame to the end frame in unit time. So our formula for the path is x of s equals x start times the matrix exponential of s times the log of x start inverse times x end as s goes from 0 to 1. The matrix exponential is multiplied on the right since the twist is expressed in the start frame, not the space frame. The path parameter s determines how far we follow the twist that takes the start frame to the end frame. The final screw path can be visualized as shown here. This is a straight line path in the sense that the twist is constant throughout the motion. Another type of path between x start and x end is one that decouples the rotation and translation. The origin of the frame follows a straight line, and the rotation is about an axis fixed in the frame. For this type of path, the position coordinates P follow a straight line path for coordinates, as discussed earlier, while the orientation satisfies a formula similar to that for a constant twist, except now just for the orientation components. These two types of paths are the most natural, simple paths between two frames. Now that we can plan paths between two configurations, in the next video we study common time scalings that turn a path into a trajectory.